morning of the year, and what a year it's been. Still, we are glad you joined us here today. It's time for a Sunday school. Let's begin. Welcome, welcome.
All by hands for a word of prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father, may our Christmas season be a time of reconciliation and peace. May the love of Christ be with us. May His peace surround us. May our Christmas be a time of healing, giving, and sharing. May your Spirit be with us as we share and care in Jesus' blessed birth. Amen.
Up to you. A poem by my grandfather, Mr. Ernest Robinson. Hello, family, friends. What's going down? What you wearing? A smile or a frown? Are you glad and happy or sad and blue? Here's good news. It's up to you. I hope you listen. I hope you heard.
To the sage advice and God's word, you can opt to win or lose. It's your choice. You choose. If I were you, I would heed his voice. Remember, he told us to rejoice. Don't remember, it's not too late. Find the reason in Romans 8:28.
Can't break free, 'cause you see. I hope it doesn't rain today. I hope things get back to normal soon. We talk about hope a lot. Usually what we means is we would like something to happen, but we're not sure it will. When the Bible speak about hope, it means something different. Hope is being confident in what we expect God to do, because we know that He always keeps His word.
This song, I love it. It just talks about God being real. There are some things I may not know. There are some places I can't go. There are places a lot of us can't go right now, but I am sure you gotta know this.
Today's memory verse comes from Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23. Let us hold on firmly to the hope we profess, because we can trust God to keep His promise.
Hello everyone, I'm Pastor Thomas Wilder. Hopefully you still remember what I look like, since it's been so long since we've had a chance to get together. But I wanted to come to you and share with you a little bit about Christmas and hopefully give you some idea of how important it is that you be a bridge of hope to someone during this Christmas season. Listen, I want you to know that there are a lot of people in this world, particularly in these United States right now, that are hurting. They're hurting because of they can't find the job, or the job they had they've lost or have been cut back. They're hurting because maybe someone that they love has died. Maybe they're hurting because the person has not died, but they're in a hospital and they can't get a chance to see them because of the COVID protocol. Whatever it is, we can't get together maybe as families, but whatever it is, there are a lot of people that are hurting. And hurt and being hurt is not the first time that this kind of situation has occurred in the world. And it points me back actually to the very first Christmas when the Jews were under persecution by the Romans and they were being occupied by them. They couldn't get everything they wanted, but yet they were hoping for a Messiah to come. God had given him his word that there was going to be a Messiah, and that's what they hung their hope on. I want to record in your hearing, not read, but just record in your hearing, the story that comes out of Matthew chapter 2, beginning at verse 1 and going through verse 13. Briefly, it says that the wise men went to Herod. Herod asked of them where Jesus would be born. They said, in Bethlehem of Judea. And so he said, go find him and bring me word again that I may worship him. When they finally found Jesus, they found him as a babe, as a young child, actually, with his mother and with his father in a house. And they brought unto him gifts, frankincense, and myrrh. Now, you can go back and read the whole part of that chapter if you like and get the details. But that's a synopsis of what it's about. Several things I want to tell you first. One, Jesus was in a house because from the time that Herod sent them to find Jesus until they found him was approximately 2 years. So Jesus was no longer a baby. That's why they went to a house and not to a stable. He was not a babe. He was a young child. Joseph and Mary were probably celebrating somewhere around what we would consider to be December. And that's why we celebrate around December 25th. The wise men generally were out in the field, or the shepherds were out in the field generally in October, somewhere around October, feeding the sheep, which was probably around the time Jesus was born. But by the time they found him, it was probably December. And again, this is around the time that we celebrate the birth of Christ. So hopefully to give you that background. But there's several things about the star I think that are very important. It was that star that kept the wise men going until they found Christ. And the key thing I want to share with you now is be like that star. Be that bridge that brings people from afar and that stays with them until they find Christ for themselves. And they're able to celebrate and they're able to give their gifts to him just like these wise men did. Several important things that I do want to just bring out or extract from the text. One is that the star was bright. It had to shine above every other star. If you're going to be a bridge of hope, then you need to be one that shines above those that are around you. Not that you're trying to be better, but you want Christ to live in you so that his light shines out of you and that you are better. You are noticeable. And you know what? Sometimes God has to bring us to a point of persecution before people really see us. They have to see us stand up in the midst of adversity. That's how you shine brighter. Anybody in the midst of adversity can go and hide themselves. But this star, through rain, sleet, snow, or hail, if it did that during the time of year, and particularly in that part of the country, it kept shining. And it shined so bright, or shone so bright, that people notice it, the wise men notice it, and that's what's important. You got to shine bright if you're going to be a bridge of hope. Second of all, you got to shine constantly. It cannot be today you're on, tomorrow you're not, today you feel like it, tomorrow you don't. Not only must you shine bright, but you must shine constantly. You must stay there. You must be there until people can find Christ. They have to be able to find Christ. If you're going to be that bridge, you have to be constant. People don't cross a bridge that sometimes falls through or sometimes crack or makes them feel uncertain about their travels. They go across bridges without even thinking about it because they are assured after having gone across this bridge so many times that that bridge is going to be constant. That's the way I want you to be as a young believer. I want you to be constant. I want you to be in season, out of season. I want you to be what God would have you be. I want you to be that bridge that so many people need during this time of year. Listen, thank you so much for being a part of the ministry here at Bethel, an important part, not just a part, but an important part. Thank you so much for listening to this. Thanks to all of our young people who have done such an excellent job. I applaud you. You have done well. I'm so proud of you. with everything you've done this year during this time when it seems like this time has brought gifts out of us that we didn't know we had in church. At least I didn't know we had in church. But thank you so much, each and every one of you. Those of you who were directors, those of you who were executive directors, who supervised your children as they did the work, thank you so much. Continue to be a bridge of hope. Continue to know that like that star, God will empower you to lead strangers from many different places to find Christ. And that's what I want you to be. God bless you. God keep you. Have a safe, have a worshipful, and have a joyous Christmas celebration and New Year's. God bless you. Thank you.
Hey kids, did you know that God loved us so much that he gave his son Jesus to die for our sins so that we didn't have to? And not only just to die for our sins, but also so that we could have everlasting eternal life. Meaning that we can know God himself, that we could know Jesus Christ himself, and that he could live in us. If today you would like to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior and ask him into your heart, if you would please pray this prayer with me. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I am a sinner, and I ask you for your forgiveness. I believe you died for my sins and rose from the dead. I now turn from my sins and ask you, come into my heart and into my life. I want to trust and follow you as my Lord and as my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And if you prayed this prayer and truly believed it in your heart, we believe that you are now saved. And we are excited for your journey as you come to know the one true God. Have a blessed day.
Tune in each week for another episode. We miss you all and would love to hear from you. Email us at ourfuture@bethelcollegeville.org or call the church office at 205-322-5360. Until next time, remember God loves you and this is Bethel, where hope lives.